Hello, and welcome back to Let's Play Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney, Trials and Tribulations. With me, TapersCrazy, where we last left off, we completed our investigation with Edgeworth into this whole murder, what's been going on at this temple. And I'm going to level with you right now. The last episode I recorded just before I went away on holiday. So the last time I actually played this game was on the 30th of July, and it is now the 1st of September, so I've gone through the entirety of August and not really picked up this game and played it. So I've skimmed through my last episode just to get my bearings a little bit, but I'll be piecing together things as I go along and sort of re-jogging my memory, so apologies if it seems like I'm being a bit slow. I mean, that tends to happen anyway, but we'll just give it a good crack, and let's get on with the, I assume, court case.
February 9th, 9:47 a.m. District Court, Defendant Lobby Number 1.
Oh my, Mr. Lorries feels that way about me?
Apparently, he isn't aware of your real secret at all. This is no time to be embarrassed.
I'm sorry. I'm just hardly accustomed to that sort of thing.
Worry not. And in any case, whatever it was that he saw on the night of the incident, mark my words, I will drag it out of him.
Does that mean Mr. Lorries is the witness today?
No. I believe that nun will be the first to take the stand.
Sister Bikini.
She claims to have seen the very instant in which you carried out the crime.
Why would you say that if it wasn't her, though?
I just want to ask you one last time. It really wasn't you who killed Miss Elise the Oak's name, correct?
That is correct. It wasn't me.
Very well, then.
Mr. Edgeworth.
Yes?
You're a prosecutor, aren't you? Are you sure about this? If your true identity is revealed...
Don't worry. I've taken the necessary steps.
You have?
Iris, it is a prosecutor's job to doubt people. But right now, I am a defense attorney. A defense attorney's job is to believe in people, and to believe until the bitter end.
Oh, so he's taking a page out of Phoenix's book then. Speaking of which, when is Phoenix going to rock up? I know he's in, I think he's in intensive care at the moment, isn't he? Because he took a tumble off the bridge. So, yeah, it's currently hospitalized. So, I get a feeling he's gonna do. What was it last time? It was Von Karma in the last game, wasn't it? When she jumped in at the last minute and kicked the doors down or whatever and saved the day. I have a feeling Phoenix might do that, but I don't know.
So, a friend of mine told me once,
Mr. Edgeworth,
you may pass judgment on me from the defendant's chair. You have a one to decide. Whether or not I am able to do the task I have been entrusted.
Well, we're managing all the other ones.
Very well, sir. I'll leave my defense in your capable hands.
Alrighty. February 9th, 10 a.m. District Court, courtroom number 7.
Okay, well, as prosecuting attorney's not in. Ah, where's my old judge?
Court is now in session for the trial of Sister Iris of Hazakura Temple.
The defense is ready, Your Honor.
Wow, it's weird seeing Edgeworth face that direction. Your hair is impeccably the same as it is on the other side as well.
The defense does indeed appear to be ready. However, the same cannot be said for prosecution in this case.
Indeed.
I'm not sure I like such blatant waste of this court's time. An empty prosecutor's chair can only mean that the prosecutor has no confidence in their ability to prove their case. Would seem this case is already over before it had a chance to begin.
I'm ready to announce my verdict at this time. This court finds the defendant.
Objection. Oh no. Oh no. What is she doing here? Wasn't she in Germany?
The prosecution stands ready.
And you are?
Franziska von Karma, prosecuting prodigy.
Von Karma, you say? Perchance you wouldn't be of any relation to the legendary prosecutor
Manfred von Karmer.
Legends are a thing of the past. I am a von Karmer. That is all. Upon a special request, I flew in today for the purposes of prosecuting this case.
Isn't a flight from Germany to the States like 20 hours or something ridiculous like that?
I am fucking tired and jet lagged. I don't know how I'm standing, to be honest with you.
Von Karmer doesn't need sleep. They're robots.
You did. Then you must be quite a big shot, eh? By the way, Mr. Edgeworth.
I can't get this guy's voice stabilized, man.
Yes, Your Honor. I'm almost certain that I've seen you somewhere before. Or am I just imagining things? You look very much like a prosecutor I met once. I believe you are imagining things, Your Honor. Miss von Karmer, do you have anything to say?
There is no such weakling as this man among those of a prosecutor's office.
Are we all playing a big game?
There isn't right.
I told you there is no such weakling.
What is that, a whip? I'm not sure I care for such a thing in my courtroom. Bailiff, remove that whip at...
Hold it. I wouldn't advise doing that.
I have no objection to the whip. But you don't?
The prosecution can wield a whip or drink 17 cups of coffee. But there is still only one truth. That is what I stand here to prove today.
This promises to be interesting, Miles Edgeworth. I had expected to face Phoenix Wright here today. But looking at you now, maybe this is what I have been waiting for all this time. Miles Edgeworth, I will not allow this chance to crush you slip through my fingers.
Edgeworth, don't give a fuck.
I see you brought your flair for the histrionic.
Allow me to add to things I'm not sure about. People acting bizarrely in my court. Rah!
The stage is set. Now continue with the proceedings, Your Honor.
Very well. Miss von Karmer, please give an outline of this case. With as little whipping as possible.
The bad victim is a famed book author, Mr. Liz the Oxman. Her body was found in the Hazakor Temple courtyard. She had been stabbed through the torso by a ceremonial sword from a golden statue.
The sword in this picture is the weapon in question, correct? Very well. The court accepts this photo of a crime scene.
Right.
There is no mistake. This was the doing of Sister Iris. After all, there is a witness to her crime.
Very well. Please bring this witness to the stand.
And so it begins. A drift story of being a defense attorney. My first and my last trial as a defense attorney. Oh dear.
Witness, state your name and occupation, please.
Hold on here. I'm not sure about being not sure if I care for this at all. Witness, please stand up nice and straight.
Oh, these games just get wackier the more you play them.
If I recall correctly, there are a few milk crates in the defendant's lobby for the witnesses with bad backs.
Bailiff, fetch a crate for this poor lady, please.
There we go.
Once again, your name and occupation, please.
Hello, me. Well, I'm the head nun of Hazakura Temple on Eagle Mountain. My name is Bikini. You got it? Bikini. Nice to meet everyone.
That face gets me every time. He's just sort of like, yeah.
But you don't appear to be wearing a bikini right now.
The courtroom is the garden of holy judgment. Souls with lettery in their hearts shall leave this sanctuary at once.
Well, he wasn't whipping the old judge. He's known for a bit of mindless lechery.
You want me to leave?
No need to get your bikinis in a twist. Let me tell you, I am a sight to behold in summer.
Ooh.
In any case, witness, I hear that you saw the crime take place on the night in question.
That's right. I can still hardly believe it myself, to be honest. There's no way dear little Iris could do anything like that.
Right. I don't see what you have to say, then.
First, tell us about it. I know he's Canadian. I know he's got a Canadian accent, but I just can't do him. First, tell us about your own movements at night, eh? It doesn't suit his face. It's sort of like, I'm an old man. And then he's like, tell us about your own movements at night, eh?
God damn it.
That night, I was helping an acolyte with her training in the inner temple. But, well, as you can see, my back likes to act up. Violently. So, I left Iris to help the acolyte and return to Hazakura Temple. There's no buffer to the inner temple, you see, and I needed a long, hot soak. It was after I had finished, just as I was heading back. That's when I saw it.
So it was simply a coincidence that you found yourself returning to Hazakura Temple.
Yes, you could say that. If my back hadn't been in so much pain, I would have stayed at the inner temple.
It sounds like a pretty important statement she just made.
There is only one problem with these testimonies that I can see. And you're not about to fall at her first head now, are you, Miles Edgeworth?
Mr. Edgeworth, please begin your cross-examination. I'm sorry. I'm trying my best. Right, okay.
What night I was helping-
Hey, what do you mean by that?
What is this inner temple?
Well, see, conversing with the spirits is what we train people to do, right?
We'll be the ones asking you the questions, madam.
In order to do that, a place strong in spiritual power is required. There's a small temple across Dusky Ridge called the Inner Temple. Acolytes must spend an entire night there to undergo intense training.
And how exactly do you help with this process?
It is all quite exacting. It can't be performed without a nun supervising. Like a tutor, watching to make sure a spoiled child studies.
A tutor with a whip, in your case. If that is the case, then why did you return to Hazakura Temple, where the murder took place?
Well, as you can see, my back likes to act up violently.
What do you mean by violently?
Violently?
That's right. It's no laughing matter, especially in winter. I can't hold anything heavier than a knife and fork during the cold months.
Oh, shit. Well, you're wearing clothes.
Just being alive is like strict training.
Stop bouncing up and down and jiggling. On the night of the murder, was this fabulous back of yours hurting again?
That's right. Raging like a bull in a pig pen, I almost fainted once or twice. I just knew that unless I warmed it up, it was going to finally finish me off.
Alright, okay. So she left Iris to help the acolyte in return to Hazakura Temple. So this is assuming that Iris is actually there then. Okay, thought so far is that we... This is Iris's testimony, so I guess it's not going to hold much water. But it says that she rang the lights out bell at 10 and then was in her room until the murder was discovered. Which to me says... Excuse me. She never went to the temple. I'm still unsure on the timeline of events of this.
You left Iris to help. With what?
What do you think? The acolyte's training, of course. It was just past 10 p.m, so you were starting to enter into the training exercises proper.
Was it your place to remain with the disciple?
Well, the job is simply to watch over the acolyte so that they don't pass away.
Just to confirm this point again, that night, you met Iris in the inner temple, correct?
Iris, yes. She's a gentle, honest girl. She's never once failed to follow my directions.
Right. Okay, there's no bath and she needed a hot soak. It was after she finished that she was heading back. It's when she saw it.
There is indeed only one problem with this testimony. If I can clearly point out what it is, then I can begin to quantify just how good this witness's memory and observation skills are.
Okay, I'm gonna take a shot on that one. Left Iris, and we'll present her with Iris's testimony.
Witnesses have to undergo their own trials, I'm afraid. The defendant's fate rests on their powers of observation and memory, after all.
Well, well, well. Don't worry, I'm moving up to the task. I'm a woman of faith, after all. The head honcho of Hazakura Temple.
In that case, Miss Honcho, I'd like you to explain something for me. The discrepancy between your testimony and that of the defendant, Iris. She claims that after ringing the lights-out bell, she went back and stayed in her room. Which means she did not go to the inner temple at all.
Objection! No, she said that. A defendant or a witness? Who is more likely to lie, do you suppose? The defendant is simply lying to cover her back.
Objection. But that is completely illogical. The murder was committed in the courtyard of Hazakura Temple. Claiming that she went to the inner temple would make for a much better alibi.
It would.
But that is odd. Whatever the reason, I can't believe that she would lie.
She does indeed have honest eyes.
Ah! All people lie. That is my belief.
Why might we all be whipped in here? Anyway, neither the witness nor the defendant have any reason to lie. Which means we must call your memory into question. I'm going from south to the north.
Dear, dear, dear. You're older than me and yet you want to play that game, do you?
Well, that isn't exactly what I...
My memory is perfect. Crystal clear. Especially in winter.
Ooh. So she's got a rough side then. Man, I suppose it's too early to end this cross-examination here. Mr. Edgeworth, if you are going to question the memory of this witness, you'll need to show me a more decisive piece of evidence.
Understood, Your Honor. I was naive to think that alone would do the trick.
Please add your comments about Iris to the testimony. And let us return to the cross-examination.
That night, I was hoping an acolyte of a training in the inner temple, but... Well, as you can see, my back legs act up violently. Iris came to the inner temple. She was dressed exactly as she had been for dinner. Hold
it! Okay.
Are you sure that you're not making a mistake?
You, young man, need to get your estimation of me up from the floor. Iris always wears the same clothes. The smallest thing out of place would have stood out like a sore thumb to me. You're making a mistake, thinking I made a mistake.
Okay, so... All is not... I'm getting the feeling all is not what it seems with bikinis. She seems to have... Particularly with her memory, she seems to be showing a bit of ego. Like, once we start questioning it, she's sort of like...
You're making a mistake.
Oh, no. Okay. An excellent finish there, witness.
Still, I have to wonder...
Yes, I do have to wonder, because the piece of evidence I've got which contradicts this is she gave her hood to Phoenix just before like the lights out bell, which was at 10 o'clock. Okay. Iris came to the inner temple. She was dressed exactly... She was... Okay.
Shut up!
Witness, let's get one thing straight. The defendant whom you claim to have met, she was wearing this demon warding hood, correct?
Of course. That is a very important piece of clothing, I'll have you know. Wait a minute.
Objection!
Hold it right there. Why do you have that?
That's the question of the day now, isn't it, Miss Von Karma? I'll have you know that this hood was given to someone as a gift that night. Before the lights out bell was rung.
The what?
You know where I'm going with this, don't you? The witness had seen the defendant as she claims. The defendant couldn't have been wearing this very hood.
Well, well, well.
Well, couldn't she have got another one then?
It's not a bad feeling at all, exposing contradictions like this. Now I understand that Happy Hill Come Right's face every time he does it.
Yeah, that really, that massive grin.